Hey, I'm Josh, and I've been full-time van lifing since 2017. This is my second van, the Boondocker 2.0, and I'm really excited to show it to you.
I mounted the sink in the doorway, so the backside doubles as a cooking or dining surface. Here's an outlet to plug a cooktop or other appliance. A big reason I put the sink in the doorway is so that I can cook with a view, but the main reason is so I can use the faucet to wash off in a pinch. These running boards make getting in and out of the van effortless. I've lived in a van for over 4 years, and having a large sink is one luxury that's a non-negotiable. I added a three-stage filter for drinking water. Honestly, I can't live without it. These storage shelves are so convenient for items that I need to access often. Here's an outlet, a cell phone charger, and a cell signal booster. I had this switch panel custom made. Its location means that all my switches and heater controls are easily accessed while I'm cooking or in the bed. Yes, you read that right. I have a radiant heater on the floor. There's no shortage of storage space in this van. 9 drawers in the living area and 2 more in the garage, a closet, and 7 additional cabinets. This drawer is on 500-pound sliders and doubles as a step to get in and out of bed. Ah, nap time on the water. There's an outlet in this cabinet for convection oven or small microwave. How about mood lighting in bed? Every square inch of storage space was maximized in this van. There's a USB outlet in this book cubby for charging in bed. It's even got a 12-volt Fresair Air Cooler for those hot and dry days. The driver's seat swivels to create a table for two, but I can also move the table. How about breakfast in bed or a cozy movie night? This is a top-of-the-line Vitrafrigo 150-liter fridge and freezer. It's very sleek and works awesome. This drawer is great for bulky or tall items. Here's the closet, but there's also a toilet that diverts urine to a tank under the van. Here I have the inverter control, 110-volt outlet, a 12-volt USB outlet, a switch for the water heater, and my battery monitor. I could fit a composting toilet here, but in all honesty, I never went number 2 in the van. I put my trash can here, and this is the vent for the Webasto Diesel Heater. This drawer is great for footwear and other small items. I installed this 3-point seatbelt seat so I could travel with a child or extra friends. There's so much storage space in this van, it's ridiculous. The MaxFan Deluxe with cover is a necessity. It also has a remote so I can control it from bed. I put an outlet down by the desk so I don't have power cords running all over the van. Okay, are you guys getting tired of all this storage? How about more storage? This is a really cool 4K camera and screen that mounts to the rearview mirror for recording the road behind you and in front. Insulated curtains are a must. Hey, the passenger seat swivels too. There is a lot of thought, experience, and detail that went into this van. Outdoor shower with hot water? No problem. There's about 45 gallons of fresh water storage in this van. It's truly made for boondocking. There's 2 40-inch storage drawers on 250-pound slides for all your outdoor gear. This slide could be used for more outdoor gear or even a bike. Hey, let's check out the brains of the van. Here's the compressor for the fridge. Here's 400 amp hours of Victron lithium. Next is your 3000-watt Victron inverter. And lastly, here's a 100-amp DC converter that charges from the alternator. Here's your battery kill switch and an extra outlet. Safety is a top priority with this CO2 and propane gas detector. There's a stealthy shore charging outlet. I love this water fill hatch, don't you? These wheels and all-terrain tires give the van a nice look while tackling some rugged forest roads. Check out this shower curtain system for added privacy. You could add a ladder to get up on that roof deck, but what's the fun in that? There's 150 watts of solar up here mounted to my custom-made roof rack. A cell booster is essential for digital nomads. Did you spot the exterior lights? This graywater hatch is electric. No more getting down and dirty. The exterior has a grill guard and is coated with a gray bed liner for extra protection and sound insulation. This van is a 3500 and has a very rare eco-diesel engine. Well, that's just about it. What do you think about this van build? I'd love to hear from you. Have a great day.